Right then, today we're going to be talking about rising damp again, moisture from the ground. Now, if you are new to this channel and you like this sort of stuff, give us a like, a subscribe or what have you. If you subscribe to this channel, I do apologise if I'm going a bit over all ground on stuff, but it is really for homeowners, this sort of stuff, showing them how we repair buildings, how we do some diagnostics. Now, again, damp. Very, very, very controversial subject. Some people even say rising damp doesn't exist, despite there being so much information out there about existing. Nobody's actually proved it doesn't exist. People have proved it exists. I think the main point of it is, though, when people get so angry about it, is because the diagnostics can be really poor, and basically the advice can be really poor because of poor diagnostics. Now, this is a classic example of it, basically, because what you find is some people is what I call the one-trick ponies. Now, some people haven't had much training, haven't got much experience, or been doing something, say, for 40 years, claiming to be an expert, but that means they've been doing it right for 40 years. Some people might have been doing it for 10 years and still not doing it right. So what I always say is, it's best to just follow the standards. So you've got the British standards out there and you've got BRE Digest 245 about how you do all the sampling. With those standards, it tells you about what we always say, the process of elimination. You go through that process of elimination and only then can you get a conclusion of what's going on and further advice on a repair. It's a very controversial subject. I hope this, I'm going to take you through my sort of survey techniques and what I found and how I'm going to repair it. In my opinion, this is the best way to repair this building. But some people might disagree with that. That is fine. I'm never going to keep everybody happy, but this is my opinion. Now, getting people angry. These things get people very angry because in this house, they spent £5,000 to have these installed in two walls. Now, if you look on here, you can see you've got three layers. One, two, three. So that was the original render. So the original renderer that come in couldn't even bother to knock this crap off. They just put something over the top because it's all very stony and shelly and gravelly. I don't know what that render is in there. And basically, it would have keyed to it, but that is still loose. When they stick these in, it's just they core 200mm holes and wang these in with a bit of sand and cement. You can even see they blocked up some of the back on there. They do have a little bit of plastic in there, which is, oh, here, so that sticks in, and that's basically supposed to blow the air around. I've done videos of these previously before. When you look at this property, this is what gets me angry. They spent £5,000, but they've missed the basics. There was no diagnostics. They've got one solution to fix this, and that is install the magic vents. And that comes down to some other companies as well. This has been damp proof previously as well. Whilst I can't say how long this drain defect is there, the one below ground, it's been there for a long, long time, looking at it from my experience. So, best thing for you to do if you're a homeowner is to pay for proper diagnostics before you start even thinking about repairs. And this one, like I say, was looked at last year. We started the work this year. We finished it ages ago, to be fair. And the reason I started it this year was because I want some warm weather to do the lime, to be fair. I know people can do the lime when it is a bit cold and that, but I just don't want any problems to go wrong. And when someone's not desperate, we do it this way. So I'm going to take you through everything. And I'm actually going to take you through one of the reasons these actually seem to have worked in a couple of areas, but they actually didn't. So, stay to the end. Any questions, drop them in the comments below. If you like this sort of video, give us a like. Hit the bell icon. I've got some more coming up, and I've got one coming up on this. Physical damp proof course from 1850s. I've got a case study coming up. Another thing, if you're interested in diagnostics, I've got some great videos coming up. I've got some case studies and I've got some really interesting stuff on ground penetrating radar. So I haven't really put much on here about ground penetrating radar. I've got to finish all the videos. I just had time. This video, as I say, from last year. but you can actually see all these culverts. So problems with damp been going on for years. You're going to see all the ones with the land drains. You're also going to see all the French drains. And I've also put like a little boat together now with like a sonar in there. It's got all the sond and all the tracing equipment for above ground, real-time lights, GoPros and God knows what in there. And we're going to basically be driving this down a culvert to find out where it goes. Nobody knows where it goes. It's never been surveyed. I can't put the video up straight away after because it's a bit of a something I can't really say about it. So I've been asked not to do any of that because they know I put stuff online. So yeah, hit the subscribe because these are going to be really, really interesting. If you've got an old building and you've got real bad damp problems as well, there's a good chance you could have a culvert. There's a good chance you could have a land drain, you know, a well and all this sort of stuff. Whilst I can't find absolutely everything, we can just do the best we can. And yeah, you might be interested in it.
Ooh, we're at a lovely old building today. And it's fair to say, they have had a long-term damp problem here. And the magic vent man's been. Just wonder if the guarantee's void. Ooh, he's been cutting off. So, these come with a guarantee. They're all different names. I don't know what this one is. I can't remember what they said it was. Typically, every job's £2,500 to £3,000. They're installed in 2 days. First day, they do the cores. Second day, they come and muck them in. Good money, you think. Damn, what do they cost to make? Just say they cost £1 each, and they chuck 50 of them, 50 quid. Good money. But, never going to fix a problem. This house would never be fixed by putting these magic vents in. You can see, got rock hard render there, it's all cracked. Galvy beads, should be stainless or plastics. This is all blown, so you know any water's going to get in there, but this is not a penetrating damp issue. What you're going to see here is basics and basic stuff. So, as you can see there, you've got a lot of modern masonry paint in the bottom there. It looks like an engineering brick, but it's not. So this is a tip for surveyors or newbies. When you're looking down here, you can see this is just... So you expect a bit of damp build, but this is like bloody mud. It's absolutely soaking wet. Yeah, lime mortar as well, but it doesn't matter, it's still soaking wet. So this is more than what I'd say a damp issue, shall we say. It's like wet, soaking wet. Ground level, they've had the ground level reduced, and there's some terrain down there and everything. You know, done a pretty good job in all that respect. I'd have probably gone a little bit lower, but you know, there you go. Now, so these magic vents have been put in all the way down here and all the way down here. It's two aces, got a stop in there. So you've got a lot of water coming down this downpipe. Now, this was below ground, I've dug this out, but I just want to show you this. Split. And also, this is going in rather than on the outside or into a gully. So you can imagine any water that's coming down here, when it's raining, if you've put, like we've done, tested the gutter, you can see it's just dripping out there. Plastic connections below ground. These ones, they're above ground. So basically, they slap about. It's not a tight fit and they're not sealed. They're not for below ground. And what happens is you get a lot of leakage there. And you can see here how wet that is. That is absolutely soaking wet. Now, I want to show you this. Straight away, you've got a displaced joint. We're only just in a little bit. So just a bit further on down is plastic down there. And we're just coming out now, and you can see again, there's another old joint there. Shot. Good picture of it all there. Thanks, Rigid. A lot of muck in there. And literally, oh, we're out now. So, if you can just see this, you can just about make out that bit of old clay pipe there. So you can imagine that's just pushed into it. And there's that first one there, you can just see that scalp there. So you can imagine now, you can visibly see how wet the ground is there. This is why this wall is soaking wet. What we're going to be doing this one here, we're going to be taking all this render off. We're going to be letting it dry down. We're going to whip these mortar joints out from the bottom there. We're going to re-render in lime, and we're going to repoint in lime. Not for a little while yet, we're going to let it dry down. I know people go on about, you can still render in lime like this, whatever and that, but I'd rather just leave it. It's only just down the road from me. It's literally about a minute drive. I can keep an eye on this, wet the hessian up if need be, so it's absolutely perfect.
Right, as earlier on, the drainage issues are the problems why these walls are damp. And you can see these magic vents in the wall. But I just want to show you, this is where the magic vent was installed. Look. It's absolutely soaking wet. Look, actually squeezing it into a ball. So do these magic vents work?
So that's the straight joint. So you can see this has been buttered, it hasn't been backfilled, look. There's nothing there. All the way through there as well, nothing there, look.
Right, so you can see the render's removed. We've done a little bit of crack stitching. It's drying down lovely now. The magic vents have all been removed. One big thing we always do is we always thermotake the wall down with really hot water. So that basically removes any residual glue that's been used for the scratch coat. You can see where these have been removed. We've pointed them all back in now. Look, lovely and dry, or drying, shall we say. Someone's had a go of a damp proof course, so you know, the damp proof course has been here. And also, you've had the magic vents. Very expensive job.
Right, back at this one today. See, lads have done a great job scatting it up, scratch coating it, bit of hessian. And if you remember, that was where the problems were with the drainage down here. But what I didn't also show was, initially, was also this one here. So again, when you're looking at this sort of building, this has had a big extension on there. And it's had long-term damp issues.
So this is the important part, reported history. We know why some areas seem to have dried down because of the magic bricks. It's literally because the drain defects have been fixed because they're not being used, these drains now. Unfortunately, the camera cut out, so I haven't got the further images, but you can see all that debris within the drain pipe. You know, that's indicative of issues where there's cracks in there and voids and everything's being washed in. Dragging the camera back along there, you can see other issues here, there and everywhere and what have you. But, you know, it doesn't really matter on that sort of thing. We know these, this is all redundant now. So this is the important part about doing a proper, thorough survey and getting to the root cause.
Then, this one goes down there to a soak away. Again, the only way you're going to prove if that soak away is any of use, you're going to have to flood it and test it, which we have done, put some water in there, but just want to show you this down here. It's an old drain. You can actually see this going through. Have a look at this. Oh, just get caught there. What can you see on top? See one. And again on top, let's see that. And again, let's just go right down to the end there. Look here, all the way down. I see we're not going any further now. 6 meters. Right, we're nearly finishing the top coat. And you can see, this is the haired scratch coat. I don't know if you can see all these little hairs. Little hairs there. This is the one that had the problems with all the drains, all the way going along there. And you can see we've made a timber bell mouth and we've repointed Binny and with lime. I personally prefer to leave the rime render short. And basically this allows a massive amount of evaporation to the base of the water because it's all been repointed in lime putty. This has all got to be floated up now. You see the hessian there to protect it. You can keep having to spray this down. Probably about a couple of weeks afterwards, but it's going on really nice. It's a nice bit of putty on there. Just got to do around the window reveals in a minute. Right, so today we're back here. Top coating on the line. You can see I had a nice scratch kit on there. If you can remember, this is where the problems were with the drains. So, top coat of lime and a bit of lime wash. You can just see here. Trusty old trowel, very worn in. I think it's about 20 years old. This lime is beautiful. Nice bit of lime putty. Been using the same company now for a number of years. Never had any problems with it. That's a lovely bit of kit. Right, just to put the about to put the hessian up. You can see it's all floated up lovely. The old lime. To be fair, it's come up really, really well. Bit of plastic sheeting to lift up down there. All the old bits on there. It's come up lovely. So now we just gotta come and spray it down so it doesn't dry it too quick. Job's a good one.
I hope you've enjoyed the video so far and you've learnt something from it. That's the main thing. So realistically, with any repairs, you've got to justify them. So as you can see, the magic vents, they couldn't be justified. The damp roof course, could it be justified? I don't think so really, because these problems have been going on for a long time with the drainage issues and all the paint and stuff like that. But realistically, why did I do what I did? Right, repair wise. So if you could imagine, the paint off at low level, that's going to promote evaporation to evaporate the moisture. The render, well, sometimes you could possibly keep it well decorated, it wasn't in the best condition. So the best product to replace it with is lime. Again, the lime is going to promote good evaporation. And obviously the cause of the issues, one of the causes, the main causes, is all that excess moisture from the drainage defects. You know, obviously that is the main thing you'd repair. So if you had literally hardly any money and you can't repair your building, staged approach is perfect. So I often deal with a lot of customers that have got lots of money, some people haven't got that much money, and a staged approach is minimum on this one would be the drains, and then you start going from there. So I hope that's been of use. I'm just going to put a picture up now of the property at the end finish, but thanks for watching. There it is, drying down. Lovely bit of nice flat line render. And you can see it's still damp at the base of the wall. So roughly a wall takes 1 inch per month to dry down. So it's still got quite a bit to dry down, to be fair, because it was absolutely saturated. But all it needs now is a few coats of lime wash, and that is it. Job done. Hope we all agree. It looks really nice. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon on the next one.